In this video, we'll show how to create your first circuit. If you haven't already, you'll need to go to tinkercad.com and create an account. Then once you've logged in, click on the Circuits tab on the left and click Create a New Circuit. This will open a window where you can edit your circuit. You can also rename it by changing the automatically generated name in the upper left. Now, all of our circuits will be using an Arduino and a breadboard, so we will need to add those to our circuit by accessing them in the menu of circuit components on the right. You can scroll down to find them, click, and drag them out into the circuit window. How you arrange these is a matter of personal preference. They start in landscape orientation. I prefer to have them in portrait orientation so the writing isn't rotated by 90 degrees. You can do that by selecting one of the components and then using the rotate button in the upper left. You can see I now have them arranged the way I would physically have them arranged if I was doing this on a real lab bench. Once you've built your circuit, you can click and drag on a blank spot to pan the circuit around. You can also use your mouse's scroll wheel to zoom in and out. If you lose the circuit and accidentally scroll it off the side of the screen, you can find it again by clicking the Zoom to Fit button in the upper left. Now, we won't be doing any programming in our first couple exercises, but this is still a good habit to get into. You can access the code by clicking the Code button at the top here. Now, by default, since this is a kid-friendly interface, it defaults to this block-based programming language. We want to get rid of that by selecting the drop-down menu and selecting Text Only. This will give you a warning that it's going to get rid of the blocks and you won't be able to go back. And this will bring up a text editor, but we are going to delete all of that code because, again, we are not using the Arduino libraries in this course. So delete that for now, and then you can close the code window again by clicking the code button. Again, we're not going to be doing any programming in the first couple exercises, but you'll need to do that when you create new circuits in the future. So the next thing you'll need to do is provide power to your breadboard buses from the Arduino, just like you would if you were using a real Arduino in a lab. So the Arduino has these banks of pins. There are the digital I/O pins that we'll talk about in a future lesson. There are the analog pins and then the power pins over here on the left. So if we want to provide 5 volts and ground, I'll zoom in a bit. You see we have 3.3 volts, 5 volts, and 2 ground pins. If we want to provide those to the breadboard, we need to wire them to the breadboard. You can do that in Tinkercad by clicking on one of the holes to start a wire. You see it'll highlight when I've moused over there. Do not drag, so click once, release your mouse button, and then click where you want the other end of the wire to be. Once you've created the wire, you can click and drag the ends to move it. So you can see I started in the wrong place there. I started in the ground pin and wired that to my positive bus, so I could either move this end to my negative bus, or I could have moved this end to 5 volts and kept this end in the positive bus, and I can go from ground to the negative bus. However, you should absolutely not do what I just did, which is just dragging wires straight from one place to another, because that is going to get very messy. Just like if you were working with a real breadboard, you should organize your wires and color code them. So I'm going to click on each of these. You can use the trash can icon to delete it or press delete on your keyboard. And you can click multiple times to route your wires. So instead of going straight across the Arduino, I'm going to click once here, send this one out to the left, and then you see it automatically bends the wire each time I click. Once I've created the wire, I also get this little pop-up window where I can change the colors. So I'm going to change my ground wire to black, and then I'm going to do the same thing to add a 5-volt wire. I'm going to make that one red. And then I'm going to connect the buses on the opposite side of my breadboard in the same way. Make that one black. And make that one red. Again, I really want to emphasize this. If you're just doing messy direct point-to-point wiring and leaving everything green, it's going to be very hard to debug your own circuits when things get more complicated later. And finally, if you mess up, you don't have to delete the wire and start over. You can click on any wire you've created previously and drag to edit these points. You can also double-click on the wire to create a new one. So here you now have your first assignment. I want you to reproduce the process you've seen in this video, create your own circuit, add an Arduino and a breadboard, and connect the breadboard buses to power and ground.